Welcome to Real Estate Radio Live, an informative and engaging hour discussing everything you need to know about the world of real estate. Your host, Joe Cucchiara, provides you with insight and guidance on how to buy, sell, finance, and invest in real estate. He also offers real estate tax management strategies, new construction advice, home improvement tips, and much, much more. And now, to guide you around the world of real estate, here's your host and Real Estate Radio Live team leader, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome in. Good afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. Thank you so much for spending some time today listening to the show, checking in. Just a reminder, we're with you 5 days a week, Monday through Friday from 3 to 4. You could tune in, listen to us a couple different ways. One is on your radio at KDOW, 1220 AM. You could also listen to us live online anytime, anywhere, I should say, during the show. Our show is live from 3 to 4, and that is at kdow.biz. kdow.biz, you could click the button that says Listen Live, and you can listen to us during the show anytime. Although the most important thing is we'd love to have you download the podcast, because that way you could listen to us anywhere at any time. We realize not everybody's schedules can accommodate between 3 and 4 in the afternoon. So if you go to reradiolive.com, that's reradiolive.com, you could download the podcast, or you get the podcast at iTunes and all the regular locations you would get podcasts. We're getting several hundred downloads a day, and it's a great way for our listeners to follow the show and get the information. We're a live show. We love your comments and questions. We encourage you, and my guess is hopefully we'll have some questions today. When I introduce my guest, we have someone that's going to deliver a lot of value for us today. You can listen to us really communicate two different ways. One is a toll-free number, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text the questions in, if you like, at 408-838-9060. And if you're listening to this via podcast, the best way to contact us is 408-838-9060. Most of you know, for almost 5 years now, the focus of the show has been education and information. My main objective is to have great guests like today, valuable guests, to deliver, you know, content, information to you, the consumers, to make you a more educated, really, in your buying, selling, your activities in and around real estate. It's pretty simple. It has so much to do with real estate. There's the buying, the selling, the financing. There's tax implications, legal implications, all kinds of different things. So we're going to continue to do that today. I'd like to invite my guest in, Byron McBroom, who will be discussing how to pay as little taxes as legally possible. He's the owner of Measured Results, and I will give my testimony after I introduce Byron. Byron, good to have you here.
Good to be here.
Yeah, it's exciting. We've been trying to get Byron on for several months, and most of it's been my problem with all my crazy schedule. So it's good to have Byron in studio for the entire hour. So again, the topic today, we're going to discuss how to pay as little taxes as legally possible. That's right, legally possible. And so before I get started and have Byron introduce himself, I'm going to tell you a little bit about how we met, how I was introduced, and why I have him on the show and think so highly of Byron and his team. As I have had the You may have heard this story before, but I had the same CPA for roughly 30 years, and for the most part, my taxes were fairly simple. Owned some real estate, but you know, it was W-2 most of my life. Over the last 5 or 6 years, however, things have changed. I've had some business. My wife is 1099, gets 1099 income. The radio show is mine personally, so there's some different aspects there that go along. So it became a little more complicated, and I would bring this up to my CPA of several years and just say, you know, is there anything else we could do here? And even though he was very, very, very capable and excellent what he did, I think it was just way, way too busy. And I think just took for granted that my returns were going to be the same, and they're pretty simple and move along. So I was introduced to Byron through another agent that I work with. How long ago was that, Byron? Maybe 6-7 months ago, maybe probably closer to a year now, maybe.
I think closer to 6-7 months. Yeah. It wasn't that long ago.
And I was on a conference call, and I was just so impressed with the dialogue and the conversation that was taking place. And Byron was preparing one of his clients really for the next year in terms of buying some property. I asked if he'd entertain new clients, and he said, well, you know, it depends. I could really help people that are and I don't want to speak out of turn, but people that are self-employed, 1099, have companies, mm-hmm. have real estate, more let's say complicated or challenged or detailed returns, right? I mean, there's really not much you could do for kind of the standard person that's W-2 and has one property or no property, or is that right?
For the person that's W-2, there's just not much.
Yeah,
I mean,
they
can have an IRA or not have an IRA.
Right.
The only thing they could really do would be like prepay your mortgage on December 31st instead of January 1st.
Yeah,
that way
go.
The first year you do it, you get 13 months of interest.
Yeah.
But other than that, you kind of just run out of ideas.
Okay. Well, I'm going to just finish real quickly because we want to get Byron on here as much as we can. So I will give the quick Reader Digest version. So Byron had me send my last three tax returns to him. I did that, and he and his team spent some time reviewing them, came back with an incredibly detailed summary, got me back a lot of money over the last 3 years. And then on top of that, some complications in the last year with some real estate that he made some incredible recommendations. And, you know, the area of expertise was just astounding and value to no end. So I appreciate not only what he did for me personally, but will continue to refer everybody I know that is in that category, because in a business that we're in, or when you're in business yourself, I think you appreciate entrepreneurs more, and you appreciate someone who takes such a passionate approach to your business, and that's what Byron does for sure. So we're going to be singing the tunes today, but also more importantly, if you have any questions about taxes at all, maybe it's related to real estate, maybe, and again, this is more so for someone that's 1099, maybe you own a company, sole proprietorship, you own multiple pieces of real estate, and you're not quite sure, you know, what you could do taxes in terms of the real estate. Any of those types of things, I would encourage you to check in, give us a call, or text during the show to ask Byron. Why don't we get started, Byron, and then maybe you could just give the listeners a little bit about your background, and then about your company, where you're located, and we'll start there.
Okay, my name is Byron McBroom. I live in Ripon, California, which is a great little town out in the Central Valley. Got into accounting quite a few years ago. I basically got into it because I wanted to be self-employed. And, you know, getting into accounting, you know, is a low-cost business to get into. So I was working at Rayleigh's at the time, which I want to thank them for paying my way through education for college.
Uh-huh.
It was a great paying job at the time. And I used to sit on my breaks because I worked night crew, and I'd read the, you know, the H&R Block or the biz tax uh-huh. guides, and I'd just read and read and read and study it. And I went through school, and it, you know, got out of school, had a hard time getting a job because uh-huh. back then there was a abundance of accountants. Now there's a super shortage of accountants. Mm. So anybody that's out there that's looking at a degree to get into.
Is that right? There's a shortage.
Oh,
now.
Massive shortage.
I didn't realize that. Really?
Oh, it's, that's why in the accounting industry, a lot of firms and everything uh-huh. are outsourcing their accounting to India.
Wow.
Because they just can't find the people. Every conference I go to is all about where do I find people?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, over in India, I guess they graduate three times as many accountants
mm-hmm.
as we do, and they're all, you know, they're just starving. There's no jobs over there, so they're willing to work. You know, they work midnight over here in a room with
right.
two monitors, and they're – people don't want to outsource the jobs, mm-hmm. but they're just left desperate to get
right.
the work done.
Interesting.
So anybody out there that's going to be graduating, or not graduating, but going into school, I would seriously look at accounting as an avenue that you – it's no fun to get out of school and not have a job.
Yeah. We have a fair amount of realtors that listen to this show. Byron, you and I talked about that. We also do live events where we have several hundred people show up. And most of them are realtors, and we also have people in my business, the mortgage financing, title, legal, a lot of different. I guess some of the suggestions, what would be some of the top suggestions, whether you're a realtor or maybe S-Corp, what would be some of the things you would walk them through and recommend?
Well, I actually I just wrote it up today for a presentation I'm giving in Reno to Keller Williams, and it's a five-step process I wrote up, actually six steps.
Uh-huh.
But the number one thing I would recommend for a realtor that's self-employed is to have an S-corporation.
Okay.
And the reason for that is a lot of the tax, you take someone that makes $100,000 a year net mm-hmm. as an example, they're going to pay Social Security tax on that of 15%.
Okay.
When you're a W-2 person, they take out 7.65 out of your paycheck for FICA and Medicare.
Mm.
and then your employer pays half of that. But when you're self-employed, you have to pay both sides. So on top of your regular income tax, you're going to pay 15.3% on Social Security taxes. So you take a guy that makes $100,000, he's going to pay $15,000 in Social Security tax, which is very beneficial. But one of the things about Social Security tax is that most people don't realize is that on the first $15,000 you make, I think it's 85% of that goes towards your retirement. On the from 15 to 45, only 35% of the money you pay in goes to your retirement, and over 45,000, only 15% goes to your retirement. So someone making $120,000 a year is paying in a tremendous amount of money, and their retirement's not going up that much. So it, you know, it you're just not getting anything for your money.
Would that be, Byron? Was that, I mean, you say for realtors, but would that cover, or would that really anybody that's starting a business or self-employed? Was it,
that would be
it
for anybody that's starting a business?
Okay, and S-corp.
Yeah, and you'll have some. The way that works is let's say a business is a Schedule C and they're making $100,000 a year.
All right.
Well, what you would do as an S corporation is you would make the same $100,000 a year, but you would break that profit into two pieces. Part of it you'd pay as a wage to yourself, and part of it you'd take as a distribution. Now, the IRS figured out a long time ago that everybody's just going to take all distributions and no wage, so they started auditing that. So what you have to do is you have to figure out what a reasonable payroll is for yourself.
Okay.
So, for instance, what I do is I always look up on the Department of Labor to find out what a reasonable salary. For instance, a reasonable salary for a realtor is on the Department of Labor is $43,000. So if you're making $100,000, you'd pay $43,000 through your W-2. You'd take out the $57,000 as a distribution. And instead of paying the $15,000 in Social Security tax, you're only paying $6,000 in payroll tax.
Wow.
So there's a $9,000 savings just right off the bat, and you're paying a reasonable compensation.
Yeah. So for the most part, anybody that's self-employed, starting their own business, you would recommend this S-Corp for the most part.
For a couple reasons. One is liability protection. I mean, if you look out there, most people in the world think you can get rich two ways. You either win the lottery or you sue somebody. And it's not about doing spending less than you make, saving the money, investing in it, doing without, you know, taking a risk, potentially going bankrupt. You know, people sign a lease on a piece of property for with real estate, and like with my wife's, we have a children's clothing store, you know, and the rent's $5,000 a month. Well, 5,000 times 60 months, there's a $300,000 obligation I just signed up for.
So, good point.
You know, part of what they make is, and that's why we can take part of this as a distribution, because part of what you make in a business is the risk that you take.
Right. All right. We are going to take our first break. We come back much, much more with Byron McBroom. If you have any questions about taxes, now's the time to call 1-800-516-1220, or you could text the questions in 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We're with you 5 days a week. Today we have our expert in the studio, Mr. Byron McBroom. He is the owner of Measured Results. And if you missed the first segment, just real briefly, he did a tremendous job for me. I just started using Byron, and I will continue to do that, and I will continue to refer him to anybody and everyone that is self-employed, because there's a lot of different things I just believe that people don't understand about taxes, and you really should have the right support. It is amazing. We've all heard for years, but it's true. It's not what you make. It's what you keep, right?
Defense wins championships.
Yeah, there you go. So if you have any questions about taxes, I would encourage you to call. Byron also is an expert kind of relating with the real estate industry, does a lot of speaking and training around the real estate agent. So if you're a real estate agent out there, and you might want to contact Byron as well. So during the show, 1-800 516-1220, or you could text questions in 408-838-9060. And again, any tax advice, I would encourage you to contact Byron for sure. He can be my personal recommendation. So, Byron, the first segment we were talking about S Corporation, maybe you could talk about minimum level and go into some of the details, really, of some of the benefits and some of the suggestions you have.
Okay, the benefit, what the corporation will do is to refresh, that it's going to save some self-employment taxes.
Right. Okay.
It also is going to give you some liability shield from your business. Mm-hmm. We talked about how everybody wants to just sue somebody,
right?
And that's how they get rich. They don't live and scrimp and save and put it away and invest. They just sue somebody and win it. But there's a couple other benefits for a corporation, too. One is the audit rates for an S corporation are tremendously less.
Hmm.
For instance, if you were a sole proprietor in a business and had about $250,000 to $450,000 in gross revenues,
okay,
you have a 3.4% chance of getting audited.
Really?
So 3.5 out of 100 get audited.
Okay.
But as an S corporation, there's only a 0.4 chance.
No kidding.
0.4%. So you cut your risk by 8 of getting audited.
And is that a simple, what would be the simple suggestion or explanation, I should say, around why?
There's two explanations for that. One is, if you're an S corporation, nobody sends you 1099s.
Ah, okay.
And so, and they just have a lower rate of getting audited,
okay,
because a lot of times if you have a business and it has more than one owner,
mm-hmm,
people tend to put less, they tend to put less personal items in the corporation, because if you and I are partners in a business and I want to spend a trip to Hawaii and, spend $8,000 mm-hmm on that, you're going, hey, why am I paying for half your trip to Hawaii?
Right, right.
So you just don't have as people putting as much stuff through, mm-hmm, suspicious stuff or, questionable stuff through a corporation as you do a sole proprietorship. Because
okay,
a lot of sole proprietors use it as a piggy bank.
Mm.
And then also, from what I understand, the IRS has a shortage of – the IRS has had a lot of brain drain because they have a lot of their higher-level auditors retiring now.
Wow.
They're facing the same shortage of hiring qualified people as the accountants are. So there's a shortage of really qualified auditors at the IRS, too. So they just don't audit the higher, the mm-hmm more complex the corporation stuff as much.
Okay.
And so that's why you've seen a lowering of audit rates over time. But mainly it's just that if nobody reports something on you, there's nothing to conflict with what you've put on your tax return.
Mm.
So it makes it, just less likely to be audited.
Okay. We have a couple minutes before our next break. What are some of the other individual benefits or some of the things you could share with our listeners?
As far as what individuals could do?
Yeah, right.
Okay. Well, if you have some rental properties, one of the things you might want to consider, and your kids are a reasonable age,
mm-hmm,
is hire your kids to work on your rental properties.
Okay.
I plugged into my tax software, and a child can make $6,300 on their working for you,
okay,
and only pay $23 in tax.
Huh.
Now, that same $6,300 deduction was going to save you $2,600 on your taxes.
Wow.
So now, the key is you have to be able to look an auditor in the eye without smiling when you're telling them what the kid did.
Right.
And they have to do some work.
Sure.
I mean, which is good for kids.
Right.
Kids learn how to work.
Absolutely.
I think my kids grew up not even know how to push a lawnmower. They were swimmers and competing in sports. So
that's another show we should do is tax and children, right?
There you go.
There's a lot to that for sure.
But it just makes sense,
yeah,
to put your kids and pay them. You're going to give them money anyway,
mm-hmm,
and if you but you have to pay them. With that, you have to do a W-2,
mm-hmm,
so you run it through payroll. But the cool thing about paying your kids, if they're under 18,
mm-hmm,
there's no payroll taxes on it.
Ah.
So
okay,
you don't. The only expense you have of paying them is to file payroll tax forms,
right?
And there's zero tax on it, so the money just goes straight to the kids, and they can use that money and buy their jeans and clothes, or they can use that money and you can save it up for their college. That's a good way to help make college a little more deductible and make it a little less painful.
All right. Well, what we're going to do is take another quick break. When we come back, we're going to continue the tax benefits, some of the things that you may not know. I encourage you to give us a call. Check in 1-800-516-1220 or text the questions 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining me this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live, and joined in studio for the entire hour here by Byron McBroom. He is the owner of Measured Results, outstanding CPA, and does an incredible job. And I'll actually throw that, what I'm going to do is, I thought about this, Byron, I'm going to throw it out there. I will almost guarantee, if anybody is out there that's self-employed, that I would almost guarantee anything, or let's bet a buck or something simple. I better be careful about anything. That if you let Byron take a look at your taxes, if you're self-employed, that he will find something that would benefit you. I just really believe in that. So if you have any questions, check in. Give us a call, 1-800-516-1220, or you can text the question 408-838-9060. Byron, we were left the last segment talking a little bit about S-Corps, and then you started, you had some suggestions about what you could do with your children. I mean, my gosh, our children cost us so much money, we might as well try to get some benefits from them, right?
It cost you a lot.
What are some of the other things that might surprise people that you could do?
Well, one of the tidbits and tricks that I like to do is the IRS has a provision, and this is for anybody with a house, or and it's mainly meant for people that have a vacation home up in the mountains. What you're allowed to do is you're allowed to rent that vacation home out for 14 days a year tax-free. Now, what this, like I said, is designed for the guy with a house in the mountains, and he rents it out for 2 weeks. He puts the money in his pocket. He doesn't have to pay tax on it.
Okay.
Well, what I do, instead of, you know, I don't have the vacation home, but the on my primary house, I hold my once-a-month corporate board meetings at my home.
Okay.
And so if I was going to have a wedding at my house, you know, what would a one-day daily rental rate be for my house, to get the backyard, to get the kitchens, the whole house?
So that's how you do
it. If I was going to throw a wedding, that's how I would value that.
Okay.
And so, like, for my house, I live in the valley, so, you know, homes are worth a fraction of what they're worth here in this area.
Right.
But for my house, it's worth about $750,000.
Okay.
And so I rent that for $800 for a one-day rental.
Mm-hmm.
So I get $11,200 tax-free out of my business, and I hold a once-a-month board meeting at my home. I actually write up the physical minutes and discuss what I talked about. And, you know, I'm on my president, I'm secretary, and I'm treasurer, so I'm there. We're all there. Me, myself, and I'm there. And I just talk, you have a meeting to go over. You know, a lot of times you can't, my justification for this is you can't have quiet time at work because I get constant interruptions.
Good point.
So this way I can go over my plans for the next month. I can set goals. I can decide what marketing I'm going to do. And I do all these things at my once a month meeting at home. And I write myself a check. I attach those minutes to the receipt, and I get $800 tax free out of the company.
Yeah. Here's the piece that, and I know a lot of people know this, but the one thing I learned over the years is that why you want to work so hard at saving the money you make or trying to figure out what kind of best tax advantages you have is because every single dollar that you could get as a tax advantage or get back instead of paying to the government or to state or whatever is worth so much more, right? We think about the dollar, but what is that dollar going to do for us somewhere else instead of in the pocket of the government or the state?
Exactly. And actually, if you think about it, the amount of money, if a properly structured tax plan, will fund your retirement plan.
Good point. That's well said.
For most people that are making $100,000, if they properly $100,000 self-employed, if they properly structure it, I can easily show them how to save probably $11,000, $12,000, $13,000 a year.
Yeah.
And that funds both you and your spouse's IRAs.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, and it's painless because it's basically being subsidized by the government, and it's. I always say if somebody drives by with a machine gun, you don't have to stand up and wave at them. And this way, I'm only going to recommend things that are legal, and you're going to have how to do them right. And a lot of it's just knowledge.
Yeah, that's a very good point. All right, we're going to take another quick break. When we come back, again, if you have any questions, and I'll throw that out there. If you are self-employed, I will bet you that Byron would find something in your tax returns. Give us a call, 1-800-516-1220 or 408-838-9060.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit RERadioLive.com. That's RERadioLive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon as we roll along. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We have in studio Byron McBroom, who is the owner of Measure Results. If you are self-employed and or have a bunch of real estate or some challenges or extremely difficult, however you want to say it, with your tax returns, this is a gentleman that could be a great service to you. If you have any questions, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text 408-838-9060. Also, Byron, for those that are listening, what are some of the best ways to get a hold of you? Why don't you give out your contact information, if you
okay.
will?
Okay, my phone number is 209-599-8989, and email is byron@measuredresults.net. And if you want to follow us on Facebook, my son works with me in the business, and he puts up some quite entertaining little videos on things like depreciation, but they're pretty entertaining, so you might want to look at that. But you can follow us at facebook.com/measuredCPA.
Very good. Very good. And I know that of all the wonderful work you do, you're also involved with some charities, some nonprofit organizations, and you do a lot of trainings, and you get involved really with the community and just giving back in general with your area of expertise. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what's coming up here in the next several months?
Okay, I was fortunate enough to be involved. A good friend of mine, Tim Rode, pretty hard-charging realtor. One, he retired early, and he got busy into helping people. You know, a lot of people just struggle in life.
Mm-hmm.
And what he did, he formed a non called One Life Fully Lived. That's onelifefullylived.org with a one, the numeral one. And they basically just teach people how to design a life, mm-hmm. how to dream it, how to plan it, and how to live it.
Hmm.
And I teach a part of that on the finances. I basically teach the ABCs of your business, of your
okay.
life. So we basically teach people what it takes to be financially independent. We talk about, you know, the Dave Ramsey stuff where the poison
right.
of debt and how to get out of debt. We talk about how to make more money.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can either, you know, ABCs is you got to have offense, you got to make more money, you got to spend less money, and then you got to learn how to invest. And so we talk about how to make more money. We talk about how to budget and live mm-hmm. within your means. And we just tell you how to put it all together to basically become financially independent.
Mm-hmm.
I think only a third of people as they retire live only on Social Security.
Wow.
They have nothing else. And another third has less than 50,000.
Wow.
And only just a small percentage of people are what's considered financially independent.
Yeah.
And so they really like to teach, you know, the focus of that is to mm-hmm. teach people financially independent. But the nonprofit is really a lot more than that. I mean, they teach people how to goal set.
Mm-hmm.
And your dream, your design is not just money. It
yeah.
can be, I want to travel around the world. You know, I want to find a good house,
right.
spouse, you
right.
know.
Could be anything.
Could be anything. Fitness. They always have fitness
yeah.
challenges on them.
You know, one of the big things, and we'll definitely do a show on this, I'd love to. There are a lot of people in the Bay Area that are house rich, cash poor. So they're sitting in homes that are worth $1.5-2 million. Maybe they own nothing on it or very little, and they have done. You know, unfortunately, they haven't done a very good job in investing or 401k or whatever, and maybe they have no pension. Might be living on Social Security. So they have this home that's worth $2 million, and they don't know what to do. They don't want to move. They don't want to sell it because of the huge tax hits. One of the things that I was talking to someone about, and we could do this. Is the idea of meeting with someone like that and explaining to them how they could potentially rent their home out for the next 2 years, have it become a rental property. Once after 2 years, is that right? Then it becomes a rental property. Then they could do a 1031 exchange if they were to sell that. Is that correct?
If they wanted to take it to, if they'd have to be willing to move to a different area,
yeah, well,
obviously.
That's what I mean. So let's say they moved from this $2 million home and rented it for, and here, believe me, $12,000 a month. It's crazy what people pay for rent. So they could do something like that, rent it for a couple of years, collect that income, which would in turn maybe pay for their condo by the beach or wherever they're living temporarily. And that, I mean, I, again, it's not meant for everybody, but I guess what I'm trying, what I really enjoy is trying to figure out, you know, what is the best situation for people like this? There's a lot of calls I get about people going like, Joe, and typically they just say, well, reverse mortgage. And maybe that's a good solution for them, but we'll talk more into detail another show. I'd love to do another show basically on 1031 exchange and how that benefits people. But anyway, you made some really good points here. Before we cut out of this segment, what else do we have here that might surprise people, or maybe some stories or examples? We have about 2 minutes in this segment.
Well, one of the things that I've come up with recently, and I wish I'd have came up with this when my kids were in school, is a way to make most of your college education tax deductible.
Mm.
And the way I do that is if you take someone with a business,
okay,
most people have payroll.
Mm-hmm.
So what you do is you form a corporation owned by your children, an S corporation, and you'll have them take over the job of hiring all your employees.
Mm.
You have that make a reasonable salary. And ideally, you'd have that salary be approximate to what you're spending in the school.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say your kids were going to go to a private school and you're spending $50,000 a year for that.
Mm-hmm.
If that business made $50,000 profit, what would happen with that is that profit would be taxed at the kids' rate, not yours.
Mm.
So part of it would be at zero, part at 15, part at 25, when a higher tax person might be in a 28 and a 9% state bracket, so they're in a 37.
Mm.
And by doing this, what it does, it saves after expense, after paying for the formation of the corporation, after paying the taxes on the corporation, after paying me to do the return, it saves about $10,000, $11,000,
$12,000
a year.
Wow.
So it subsidizes your college education.
Yeah, big chunk.
So that works for anybody that has payroll, say, okay, through their business.
All right, very good. All right, we're going to take one last break. We're going to come back and finish up. Again, if you have any questions for Byron, 1-800-516-1220. Or you could text 408-838-9060. We'll be back to continue and finish up the show in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart. Tune in and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon as we wind down the show. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. I've been joined in studio for the entire hour by Byron McBroom. He is the owner of Measured Results, has done a tremendous job with my taxes, and I will continue to toot his horn because he's done a great job for self-employed people for sure. And so before we, there's a couple texts here, Byron, I'll just read real quick. One references that seminar that you were talking about, whether it was good or is it good for children. So you're suggesting something like this in Sacramento would be for someone that's actually started paying some bills, maybe not 15, 16, but maybe in their early 20s or maybe out of college, got their first job, things like that.
Well, the original program was designed to teach high school kids how to be financially responsible.
Okay.
What they found over the years is that when you're spending mom's money, it's not that important.
Yeah, it's true.
And so, but they're over the time, now what they're starting to do is they're starting to develop more kids programs. So for this one in October, there's one coming up October.
Uh-huh.
22nd and 23rd in Sacramento,
uh-huh,
and I think it costs $125, and your dinner's included, or you'd have to look on the website to get the exact numbers, but it's well worth it. You have experts come in and talk about a variety of subjects, but they even had, for example, one of the ladies that was Oprah's financial advisor,
uh-huh,
came in, and her specialization was teaching kids ABC's money.
Oh,
excellent. So a lot of it is focused on how to teach, mm-hmm, your kids money, and I know they're going to have a big push on teaching kids and little kids, even 5- and 6-year-old kids, the principles about money, because this is something you don't learn in school.
I think it's a flat shame that there is an English history math requirement and no money, no financial requirement.
Yeah, why
isn't
not,
it? Think about it.
Yeah,
right?
Why not balance your checkbook?
Exactly.
Here, balance the checkbook. Here's how to live within your means.
Yeah.
It's just not
taught. Invest 10% of what you make. All these little simple things, right?
Yeah, and most people learn it from their parents, but their parents did a terrible job.
Yeah, good point. All right, we got a couple minutes left. We'll make sure. So another quick text here, and I'll respond. It says, hello, Byron. Can a self-employed person contribute to both in SEP IRA and Roth IRA? What would the max amounts be in the SEP IRA?
The SEP IRA is going to be a function of what you make. So it's going to be a percentage of what you make. And there's a cap on it, but to be honest with you, I don't have that memorized on the top of my tongue. As far as the, can they do both? Again, I'm going to have you, if you can shoot me an email at byron@measureresults.net, I'll look that up and get back to you.
Okay. Those are some good questions. So before we go, one more time, for the people who text or anyone else listening to the show, the couple different ways, the best way to reach you would be what?
It's phone number is 209-599-8989, and my email is byron@measuredresults.net, or you can follow us and message us on Facebook, and that's facebook.com/measuredCPA.
Great. And then if they want to know more about the West Coast Conference in Sacramento, that's also on your website, I'm guessing?
It's actually on onelifefullylived.org. I'll be putting up a link on that on my website, too.
Okay, very good.
Real good program, though.
So in summary, we have 30 seconds left. What would be your summary to the person out there that's self-employed? What would you encourage them to do?
Self-employed, number one thing is to have an S corporation. Let's hire your kids if you have kids and they're reasonable age. Let's rent the house to the corporation, get some tax-free money. But really the best thing you could do is have a good set of books. You know, there's a lot of software out there right now that all I do is take pictures when I charge something, and the receipt goes automatically into my QuickBooks online, and I throw the receipt away.
All right, we got much more time. Unfortunately, we got to go. Byron, thank you so much. Great show, great information. This is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. Thanks for tuning in today. Thanks for continuing to tune in. We'll be back with you tomorrow. Take care and have a great afternoon. Go.
You've been listening to Real Estate Radio Live. For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Tune in, log in, download our podcast, discover more at reradiolive.com. reradiolive.com.